It's my privilege to rise today and move third reading of Bill 24, the Forest and Prairie Protection Amendment Act. I want to thank all members on both sides of the House for their discussions about this important piece of legislation. It is clear from comments made throughout the debate of this bill that members are supportive of the enhancement of wildfire prevention, enforcement, and operational activities. The modernization of this Act is an important step in reducing the risk of human-caused wildfires. As we pointed out earlier, approximately 70% of wildfires over the last 5 years have been linked to human activity, and this legislation will introduce measures that will help reduce the risk of human-caused wildfires and enhance firefighting operations. They include strengthening penalties to serve as a deterrent, simplifying the process to restrict recreational activities when fire conditions are hazardous, officially designating March 1st as the start of wildfire season, and clarifying operational roles and responsibilities. During the second reading debate and the Committee of the Whole, we discussed several aspects of the legislation. I'd like to take some time to address some of the discussion points to make sure there is clarity. During debate, there were questions about the provisions related to delegation of authority. What we want to ensure is that frontline staff who have the most experience with how this legislation works on the ground have the ability to make decisions where appropriate as part of their day-to-day duties. Of course, higher-level decisions will still be made by the minister as required. In terms of the part of the bill that addresses the wildfire season, starting the season 1 month earlier than before will allow our wildfire managers to identify potential issues and ensure fire permits are obtained earlier in the year. An early wildfire season will allow our wildfire managers to be ready to respond when the spring comes. It won't in any way affect the contracts we have in place. These contracts are multi-year, ensuring the resources are available as needed and can be extended in the fall based on hazard. This government will continue to ensure we have all the firefighting resources we need to keep Albertans safe from the risk of wildfire. During this last wildfire season, the government enacted an off-highway vehicle restriction to help reduce the likelihood of wildfires started by exhaust or hot debris. This was done using a provision of the Act mostly reserved for forest area closures. The new provisions in this Act will allow us to implement an OHV restriction in the same way that we do a fire ban right now. We are essentially simplifying the process. I was incredibly pleased and honoured to introduce Bill 24 into the House on the same day the Premier recognized the Fort McMurray wildfire first responders. This bill will help them do their job, and I'm proud to stand in this House today for its third reading. We will now move on to updating the Act's associated regulations over the winter in time for next year's start of wildfire season on March 1st. Again, I would like to thank all members for their support on this bill and for their support of our wildland firefighters. That concludes my comments, Mr. Speaker. Thank you.